That night, there was a rather fearful gaze in the room of Sam. I myself went up on the deck from my rather small cabin as I could now see. My primary intention was to get a breath of fresh air in contrast to the overwhelming smell of burning oil lamps below decks, despite the hard climate conditions. I noticed an island dead ahead of what I found that and was fascinated by this great view. I suppose we were approximately 50 meters out when I myself had realized that we were on a direct flight towards a small island. I could not be positive that the steering gear was perhaps broken, but nevertheless, we were not turning. It was at this time I realized that there was no turning back, as we proceeded to climb up the island and approach the land. Lifted up, the iron hull was groaning against the rocks in a very fearful manner. The oil lamps then proceeded to blow out all at once, and the Altona was plunged into absolute darkness. We have sharp, half the class of the SS.
It was when the ship started rolling over that I woke up. Immediately, I went up to the stairs and saw officers loading lifeboats. I climbed the ladder and boarded it. Turns out the lifeboats didn't make it. I got a crate or something float in the ocean until the steamboats from the island we crashed into arrived.
The captain ordered us to load passengers and release the boats. We hadn't even got to when the starboard lifeboat was in the water. We hadn't got nearly enough time to lower the boats. If the sinking was 10 to 20 minutes, we could have at least got one off. Officer Red Creator, SS Altona.